Hey friends, this is Jayendra Khatod and you are watching Chart the Best Fit on Azure. In this episode, let's pick up another Azure service to deep dive into its pricing and sizing aspects so that you can learn to create the most optimized consumption plan for your customers. It's my pleasure to welcome again for this episode Srinivas Manian, who is our expert cloud solution architect for Azure Core, that is infrastructure workloads. Manian, welcome, and over to you to talk about Azure Site Recovery.
Hello everyone, thanks Jayendra for the introduction. Azure Site Recovery is an important service for building resilient services for your infrastructure and application workloads. Today I would be walking you through the Azure Site Recovery service and the solution creation on Azure. Let's understand the Azure Site Recovery service, how you could minimize your business disruption using Azure Site Recovery, or which we can also call as ASR. So today, outages can strike across any of your layers on your infrastructure, right? It could be your infrastructure, your platform, and your software services. And it's going to be a shared responsibility when it comes to building resilient and infrastructure and services for your application workloads. Typically, if you look at on-premise today, how we are running your resilient services, the customer has a complete responsibility in managing your infrastructure layer as well as your on-prem, your application layers on-prem. So when you are migrating, when you're modernizing infrastructure and you're adopting infrastructure as a service platform, so the provider, cloud provider such as Azure, is offering resilient services on the platform itself, which can be leveraged to build better resiliency at infrastructure and the platforms. As you are building, going towards cloud native services by adopting some of the platform service, we further enhance the resiliencies where we manage your application and your runtime, middleware and your runtime layers. From a software as a service, you have resiliencies covered for both the stacks, which includes infrastructure and application stacks, by the provider itself. So today Azure has built-in services for high availability, disaster recovery, and backup. So let's look at some of these in detail. So outages generally are not always caused by nature. The way disaster has been categorized from a geo failures, right? So there are instances where your outages could also occur from your hardware failure. It could be a cyber attack, power failure, or a network failure. So these are some of the data from the surveys done through Forrester. So we have to be prepared in event of any of these circumstances. So business continuity planning focus around how we could minimize the downtime for the critical applications, for critical workloads as well. So talking about the building resiliencies, we would need to consider the application resiliency from a disaster point of view, any catastrophic failure, and how quickly you can recover and resume services. Secondly, about your data itself, talking about the backup service, which needs to be incorporated and from the design, which helps you to restore your data to the original point in time. And high availability for your mission critical applications, for those services that needs to be highly available at all times. So you would need all three when you plan for your business continuity. So Azure Site Recovery provides you the capability to minimize your downtime. It helps you to mitigate the data loss by near continuous replication of your source data in your secondary region. So it has ability to orchestrate, and you can schedule your replication between the two regions. So the source region, as you can see here, you could deploy them in your prime in the respective geographies, right? So every geography has a paired region concept. You have your primary and secondary data centers, designated data centers in each geography. In India, for example, we have Central India and South India are the two regions which are classified as a paired regions, where we have these resilient services built in. So Azure Site Recovery is going to help you to minimize the impact of any outages by reducing the time required to restore your applications. So one of the key things that would drive your design for your high, for your resiliency and for your BCP would be your RTO and RPO. These are the SLAs. So RTOs basically covers the maximum amount of time a data can be lost in case of any disruptions. So how far you could afford the data loss. While RTO determines that amount of time it takes for from the time of disruption to bring back your service for your users. So for this to be established, we need to have the services to provide for those data replication in a secondary region so that you are able to recover the data as per the RTO, and also you're able to bring back the services and in time as per the RTO. So Azure Site Recovery provides a complete disaster recovery solution for your workloads. So here you have different scenarios. So ASR today protects your workloads, whether it's deployed on your Azure cloud or is it being deployed on your data center on Hyper-V or VMware, and native solutions as well. It's easy to deploy and manage. And since this is a PaaS service, there is no requirement for additional infrastructure. So there is a reduction of infrastructure costs. With DR, with orchestration, you're able to minimize the downtime with dependable recovery. And there is heterogeneous environment support as well. From a management plane, Azure Site Recovery provides capability to secure your access through the right level of authentication, improve your monitoring and reporting functionalities as well. Some of the key features, just to re-highlight. So ASR provides application level consistencies. You are able to execute DR drills for your application in a periodic timeframe within a year. And you are able to have a very intuitive graphic UI where you can for the ease of operation. And it is backed by the SLAs for your RTO and RPO. From a pricing perspective, Azure to Azure, it's going to be the same cost as per the region where you're hosting those environments. And ASR licensing would be $25 per VM. And then we also need to consider the network cost, keeping in mind there would be a compression implemented for your respective workloads. So from a network standpoint, the cost would be relevant to the inter-region transfer which is going to be the egress and ingress cost. So in terms of the compute, when you are building a solution using ASR, you do not need to have your compute running in the target infrastructure. So compute can be shut down or deallocated. You only pay for the storage cost. During the time of actual DR, you can start your compute services, and then for the period of time you are running those compute services, you will be paid for that. So let us look at how we can solution Azure Site Recovery on pricing calculator. So this is a link where you can access your Azure pricing calculator. You'll find various services that you can include for your solution design. So let's select the service for Azure Site Recovery. So once you select the service, you have the following options here. So first would be your region where you would like to run your Azure Site Recovery service. So let me select Central India. And you have the two options provided as an input. So first option is recovery to customer-owned sites. So this is basically you have a DR as a service wherein you're running your on-prem workloads and you have an established disaster recovery site on Azure region, and you would like to restore back from your Azure to your primary region, which could be your customer-owned sites. The second option is you have your primary applications running on a Azure region, and then you have built resilient services to your secondary regions. So here you are looking to recover to your Azure primary region itself. So assuming I'll provide an input of 5 instances, and this is going to be the cost of the 5 instances where you're going to perform recovery to your customer-owned sites. Similarly, if I have for those application workloads running on Azure regions, let me also provide an input here. And this is the cost per VM where you are going to recover onto your Azure itself. So there is a difference in the cost when you are going to recover to your customer on sites against your recovery to your Azure DCs. And this is going to be your monthly consumptions for the number of VMs that has been selected. Another aspect I did mention is about the network cost that would need to be included when you are planning for your ASR between the regions. So this is the network pricing. So here you would find the details around the data transfer cost for between the region and across the regions as well. So here, how do you compute the solution on the pricing calculator? You can go and select bandwidth. So when you select the bandwidth service, you have the following options. So the data transfer is going to be inter-region between the two DCs, the pad region. So I can select the two pad regions here. I would select Central India and South India. And total outbound data transfer for the continuous replication, I would need to compute that basis on the number of workloads and the size of the workloads, which is going to be considered for the replication scope. So let me key in a value of 1000 GB. So this is going to be my bandwidth or the network cost for replicating data of 1000 GB on a monthly basis. So this completes the solution on Azure for Azure Site Recovery. I hope you found it useful. So that completes the solution and walkthrough of Azure Site Recovery Service. Hope you found the details useful and you would be able to incorporate those inputs while you're designing the solution on Azure. Thank you.
Hey, thank you so much, Manian, for joining us today and sharing your knowledge and insights on how to create the most optimized consumption plan for Azure Site Recovery. Thank you. And that's about it for this episode, folks. Signing off, this is Jayendra Khatod. Until next time, keep learning.